Let's open the book. Down in the well. Down in the well, deep down in the well, deep down in the very bottom of the well, there was no water. But down in the well, deep down in the well, deep down in the very bottom of the well, there were spiders and slugs and slithering snakes and the prophet Jeremiah. What was he doing down in the well? Deep down in the very bottom of the well. He was waiting, that's what, and wondering and wishing for someone to pull him out. God had whispered in the prophet's ear, you see, and Jeremiah had passed the message on to the king.
God says you must change your ways. Do what is right, or he will let your enemies, the Babylonians, conquer your country and turn your people into slaves.
The king did not want to hear this message, and he didn't want anyone else to hear it either.
I don't want to listen to this prophet, and I don't want anybody else to hear him either. Let's get rid of him. Throw him down that well.
So he had God's messenger, poor Jeremiah, dropped down in the well. Deep down in the well. Deep down in the very bottom of the well. It was dark down there. Too dark for Jeremiah to see. But it wasn't too dark for God. He saw Jeremiah brush a spider off his face. And he watched as the snake slithered closer. And then God did something. He whispered into the ear of one of the king's servants, a man called Ebed-Melech, and he told him to go and fetch his dirty laundry. Down in the well, deep down in the well, deep down in the very bottom of the well, dropped Ebed-Melech's laundry.
Hey, what's this?
My clothes. Everything but what I'm wearing on my back. I've tied them together like a robe. Now wrap them around you quickly and I will pull you out.
And so, more determined than ever to pass on God's message, the prophet rose up from the well, right up from the well, right up from the very bottom of the well.